Original hits.
The fantastic hit mix.
The album with the most hits.
Driver.
That's what Dad says.
You know he's only joking. Taxi Driver was on television. That's how we first heard about Alex. We were the lucky ones.
Doesn't he know who his real mother is then?
No. I'm his mother now, Carla.
Because he's adopted. An extra fuss.
Like today.
Alex got £20 from us.
For his finding day or whatever it is.
I only got £10 on my birthday.
That's not fair.
I know. But I've got used to it.
We may speak with tongues.
Yeah.
Our eyes are on the glory. Hallelujah!
Dear Lord, help us find our son Winston.
Amen. Amen.
Who disappeared from home 15 months ago.
Amen.
Fill him with thy spirit.
Yeah. Yeah.
And send him home to his sorrowful mother.
Amen.
Do you think they can really find people like this?
Yeah.
Good afternoon, sisters. Care to join the meeting? Right here.
you are. What did you buy that for? You're going to spoil your tea. It's not fair.
Well, I don't see that it matters at all.
You shouldn't give him more. You shouldn't make a difference between them.
Well, I'm just fond of the boy.
Fond of the love, Laura?
No, I didn't say that.
But you gave her £10 and him £20.
Well, it's my money. He put in his post office savings book. He wanted to buy a bicycle, didn't he?
That's not the point. We treat them equally.
Oh, do we? Well, I'm sorry if I've been too generous.
That's not what I'm saying.
I don't seem to ever get anything right. Ah, look at him. Poor little orphan.
He's not an orphan. He's our son, our child.
Yeah, he's not your own flesh and blood, though, is he?
Oh, that's a ridiculous thing to say, and you know it.
Blood's thicker than water.
I hope you don't say that to him.
It doesn't make it any less true, does it? You're never one for plain speaking, are you?
We love Alex as if he's our own. Remarks like that don't help. They do damage.
Oh, well, I know. I'm just a useless old woman.
Need any help?
No, thanks, Laura. We're fine. And all those can go in the dishwasher, Mother. There's no point in washing them up.
All right, I'll just sit down here, get my breath back, and then I'll be out of your way. I was wondering later, if you've got nothing special for Alex to do, whether he could walk back across fields with me. Mrs. Angel's hoping to see him.
Oh, when his friends have gone.
Of course. She's such a lonely old woman. She's always so pleased to see him.
We won't stay long, I promise. It means so much to her.
But Dad'll be home soon. He was so sorry not to be back for my party.
Well, just 10 minutes then. She may have a present for you.
Hello, Angel dear. See what I brought you.
Hello, Mrs. Angel.
Oh, he's a lovely boy. I could eat him. Do you like it? If you like it, boy, you may keep it.
He's so like her, Angel. The eyes. And the mouth. And the hair. It's the same as hers, burnished gold.
If you say so, my dear.
That is a picture of Mrs. Angel's daughter, one of her most precious possessions.
That'll do, Amy. Don't keep on at the boy.
Well, time to go home.
It's good of you to come and see me on your special day.
I'll stay here and talk to Mrs. Angel. And don't say anything to your mum and dad about the picture. Stuff it in your jacket. And when you get home, put it away in a drawer. Here.
What you got there then?
A present.
Let's have a look. No, it's all right. I'm not going to hurt you. She give you that then?
Mrs. Angel, yes.
You know where it is?
It's her daughter.
That's right. Go on.
Dad!
Hello, Ginger. Happy birthday.
Sorry, Dad. Got to go to the toilet.
because I got £20.
It's not fair. I only got £10 for my birthday. You shouldn't make a difference.
Well, could be the other way round.
Only it isn't. It's because she likes you more than me. It's like it's you she always takes to see Mrs. Angel. I never get asked.
You go instead of me if you really want. I don't like going. It's like I'm a bunch of flowers or a box of chocolates or something. Like
what?
I'm a present. Like I'm a present for the witch.
She's not a witch. Come on.
She was 81 years old, Alex. That's a good age to be. She just fell off a chair. That's all. That's what they think at the hospital. Her heart gave out.
There was someone with her last night, though. A man in a raincoat. He was waiting outside. He drew the curtains. A man with a scar.
Yes. That's Mr. Foles. It's Mrs. Angel's nephew. He was at the hospital tonight. Why did you mention that?
I just thought I ought to tell someone.
He just called in to see her last night, that's all. I know he looks alarming, but he can't help that, you know. He said his aunt was perfectly all right when he left her. He offered to help her to bed, but she wouldn't let him.
Mrs. Angel had a daughter, didn't she?
Yes.
What happened to her?
Well, nobody knows. She just got up and walked out of the house one day, that's all. Disappeared. It's very sad. How did you know about that?
Something Gran mentioned.
Gran has taken you to see Mrs. Angel quite a lot, hasn't she?
Yes.
What about yesterday?
Well, Gran did say, because it was my final day, Mrs. Angel might give me a present.
And did she?
No. She did give me things sometimes.
What sort of things?
Little things. I didn't want anything.
No, I'm sure you didn't. Forget about it. Come on, get to bed.
Is he asleep?
On his way.
Did you tell him?
I told him she was dead, yes. I thought the truth was best.
You look exhausted.
I feel it.
There's some wine left.
Okay. Something else. Something you ought to know. It's about Alex.
Trouble this is going to cause.
Well, nothing's fair in this life, my girl. Now, Laura's your daughter, and she's far cleverer than Alex by a long chalk. Why don't you just lop off a bit of her brain to even things up a bit? That's no sillier than trying to deny Alex this little windfall.
A little windfall? Is that how you see it? As if she'd left him a few pence for his piggy bank.
What are you talking about? Nothing to do with you, miss.
I don't want a piece chopped off my brain, thanks, Gran. I came out to stop, that's all. And you were shouting.
It's not her fault, Mother.
What windfall? How much did Mrs. Angel leave, Alex?
Oh, trust you to ask that.
I can't keep plugs in my ears. I was trying to do my homework.
Look, I didn't know you were there. And it's a secret. Alex is only a little boy. You say nothing to him. Do you hear? Nothing. Your father and I don't want him to know anything yet.
Is he going to be rich?
I'm afraid so. Oh, why don't you tell her, Mother?
Well, Mrs. Angel left everything, house, her money, to be divided equally between Alex and her daughter. But nobody knows where the daughter is. She might even be dead. So, unless she turns up, or unless the lawyer's able to trace her, then everything will go to Alex. Do you understand?
Of course, I'm not stupid. But I don't understand why. I mean, why she left Alex anything? He's not a relation.
That's a question I'd like to have answered.
What happened to the daughter?
She was a nurse. One day she walked out of the hospital where she was working and never came back. That's why Mrs. Angel was so lonely. That's why I took Alex to see her.
Well, I think it's unfair.
And you've every right to. I'm sorry, Laura.
Well, I don't mean about the money. I mean, it's unfair not to tell Alex. Keeping it a secret. If I were him, I'd want to know. I'd be furious.
He will know. When your father and I decide the time's right, but that isn't now. Now, darling, be a good girl and try to put it out of your mind. And by the way, have you finished that maths homework yet?
Yes. I'm going out. Where's Alex? Has he got my bike?
He's over there. There's a man come to see Angels. See ya. What are you doing?
Shh, he'll see me.
Who is it?
That thing. Keep still, it's Mr. Phones.
Who's he?
It's Mrs. Angel's nephew. He's taking all her things.
So? He's not a burglar.
She's only just dead, though.
Then it doesn't matter to her, does it? Or to you. You didn't like her very much, did you?
I did not like her.
You told me you never liked going.
I didn't.
What were you hiding for, anyway?
I don't know. I don't like him.
He's her relation.
Well, I suppose they're his things now.
Leave that.
I didn't know the iron was hot.
Look what you've done. I've only just done this. Oh, go and wash those hands.
Alex, why don't you knock? Boys ought to knock before they come in a girl's room. They might see something they shouldn't. Go away, Alex. We're talking in private.
Don't be mean. You're a best friend, aren't I, Alex?
Shut up. He's far too young for you, anyway.
Oh, I don't know. Girls often marry younger men, don't they? I mean, I know Alex and me, well, we're a bit young at the moment, but we could have a secret engagement. I'd like to marry a rich husband.
We could have a yacht.
Stop it!
And a private aeroplane.
Stop it!
And a Rolls Royce.
I'll never tell you anything again, ever!
We could live at the Ritz.
What's she on about?
Well, it's nothing. Just a stupid joke. Please go away, Alex. I'm sorry.
Doesn't he know? Pardon me, if he doesn't know, then it's me that ought to say sorry. I didn't know it was a secret.
What secret? What don't I know?
I didn't have time to tell you. It's all your fault bursting in. I'll never forgive you. See what you've done now, thief.
Angel's daughter. Mrs. Angel gave it to me. It's a present for my finding day. Gran said I looked like her. That's why Mrs. Angel gave me the picture. I think that's why, anyway.
I think I can guess. What did Gran say to you, Alex? Come on, out with it. Oh, come on, even you must have seen what she was up to. No, I don't suppose you did.
What have I done? Why are people shouting at me?
Who?
Both of you. You and Laura. What's this secret?
Poor Alex. You don't know what it's all about, do you? Look, there's something you ought to know.
Isn't it?
Yes.
Foundling comes into fortune. An abandoned baby found on the Thames embankment 11 years ago is the surprise heir to an elderly widow, Mrs. Harriet Angel, 82, who died recently. But what's it mean? You can read, can't you? It's about you, isn't it?
Yes, but what do you mean about fortune?
A lot of money, I don't know.
Is a fortune.
Well, after she's left you the house, that's at least £100,000.
Pounds?
Yeah.
I don't believe it.
You lucky swine.
But my mum said.
What?
She said it was enough to buy a bicycle.
I object to your calling like this. You'll get no quotation from me or anyone else. Yes. Yes, we've seen the report and we've no comment to make. We're making no statements to the press. Now I'm busy. Will you please let me get on? Well, that was the sixth so far. How do we stop them? They'll be at the door next. Where have you been?
With Willie. He showed me the paper. I didn't know it was so much money.
Oh, you poor baby.
Poor seems to be an odd word to use in the circumstance. I thought you'd explain to him.
I tried to, but it's not an easy thing to explain to a child that everything's changed, that he's set apart from the rest of his family.
What does she mean about everything changing?
Nothing. Just like to be fair, that's all. We both tried to treat you and Laura equally.
We were so happy. We were such a happy family. Now everything's spoiled.
Well, Laura can have the horrible money. I don't want it.
Look, listen. What money there is, how much or how little, will go into a fund for you until you're older. Until then, it doesn't concern you. The best thing you can do is forget about it.
She could be your proper mother. That's what Mum thinks Gran was hinting at. I think she's more scared than anything.
Scared of what?
About the bits in the paper. In case someone sees them. Someone from your real family. And comes to take you away. I mean, you must have had a real mother. And she might be poor. If I were you, I'd be interested.
You're not me, and I'm not interested.
I know, but if I'd had a little baby and couldn't look after him, I'd like to think he thought of me sometimes. I know if he didn't, I'd be dreadfully sad.
Give over.
I know that if I'd been adopted, even though I love my mum and dad, I'd want to know about my real parents. And if I had some sort of clue, like you've got, I'd want to investigate it. I wouldn't be miserable about it.
I'd kill myself if anyone came back.
You
could always hide, I suppose, if someone came back. There's a good place in the loft, at the back of the water tank. You could hide there. I'd help you. I wouldn't tell anyone. I wouldn't tell even if I was tortured.
I think you're just spiteful. You're as bad as Gran making up stories. You're just nasty.
I suppose we've gone running to Mum and Dad now. Poor little boy, complaining about your spiteful sister.
Hello. Are you Alexander?
Yes.
Good. Lovely. Do you mind just... that's it. Lovely smile.
No.
Just look at the camera and smile, sonny boy.
Don't smile. Come away.
You're a lovely young lady. What's your name?
What's the matter, Laura? What's happening?
It's him. He's taking pictures.
The local paper, madam. Just want a few shots of the famous little boy. Are you his mother?
No, I'm Alex's grandmother.
No. I tell you what, I'd love a group photo of the three of you together.
Mum said we're not to talk to the press.
No, I'm sure his mum will be thrilled.
No, she won't.
I'm afraid she's right. I'm so sorry.
Okay.
Do you always do what people ask?
What?
Just standing there smiling.
I didn't smile.
You were going to until I stopped you.
I don't see that it matters all that much, Laura.
Standing outside his house, grinning. Everyone will know now. Not just a few kids at school. Everyone will know where you live, what you look like.
Don't bully the boy, Laura. Taking it out on him. You're as bad as your mother. Anyway, I don't see the reason for all this palaver, fuss. Except, of course, that it's all my fault, as usual.
Well, it's you who took him to see Mrs. Angel, making him suck up to her.
Now, you watch your tongue, miss.
Well, you did meddle in things.
You sound just like your mother. Anyway, it's none of your business. You're far too young to understand these things.
No, I'm not.
Oh, it's just jealousy.
I heard you. I heard you and Mum.
I know I'm the one to blame, but don't take it out on him.
Well, it is your fault, making everything horrible, all the trouble.
Stop it. It's not your fault. It's mine. If I wasn't here, if I'd never been found, everyone would be happy.
Laura? Come on.
should look sharp if I were you, before the street's clear.
Did it hit me? Oh, it's so horrible. Oh, what was it? It was something slimy.
I've got it.
Oh, it's a frog. I hate frogs. Take it away.
Oh, you prat. Stop laughing. What have you got down my neck?
They don't do any harm.
So what's the drink? What you got?
I hope you wash your hands, Terry.
It's disgusting, how could you?
They don't do anything.
Just clear up, Terry. Look what it's saying to me. Just clear off.
Why don't you play your stupid game somewhere else?
Who's she calling stupid?
You.
Come on, Terry.
Come on, Jane. Get out of it. Go on.
Don't you come back at me. I'll give you a clout and lock you into the middle of next week. Now get out. Go on. And I'll get off home if you've got homes to go to. Go on.
Come on. I know it's a bit of fun.
Don't get jacket.
Yeah, what's it got to do with you and Annie?
Yeah, what has it? Yeah.
All right. Have me dinner in peace.
Go on, have it. I'm on a diet.
No, I'm all right, thanks.
I can see you're all right, but there's not much of you, is there?
That's no meal for a growing boy. Yeah, I hate to see a kid go hungry. What's the matter?
I've lost something.
What you lost?
I've lost my post office savings book and calculator.
Yeah, come on.
Get your bag. We'll go after them.
Here, hang on. I'm not going to let this run in too thick round the middle.
They could be anywhere by now.
Yeah, much good may it do them. Well, pass up your bag. You best get home and report it. You going to the tube?
Yes.
Yeah, well, come on then. Where do you want to go, honey?
I don't know. Can I come home with you? Just for the night. I won't be a nuisance.
Well, dare say I've got room for a little one. Or I could do with a spare pair of hands for me shopping. These great boys to feed. I can't give them spuds and scraps, can I? Got to keep their strength up. Now, she want to go back in there and pay for it. Here we are. Home sweet home. Times I told him to put that bike in the yard.
Get your keys again, Paul. Late, ain't you? We're famished waiting in here.
I've got me keys. I'm just keeping you on your toes. And dinner's ready when I say it, not before.
Who's this then? Eh? Not our dinner, I hope.
Well, he helped me get it. Found him up west. It's not much of a night for a little lad to be out in, is it?
What's your name?
Alex.
Right then, young Alex. I'm Samson. Well, that's what they call me anyway. Lucky I grew up to fit it, isn't it? Come here with you. You look about done in with. Just think of the magic. Ooh, sitting down. Clean off the sofa. We've got a visitor. It's your feet.
Right.
It's not my middle, Sad. Who's his thing?
He's called Alex. He came in with a shopping. Pole picked him up.
They're getting younger.
Oh, hello, Alex.
Oh, look, the kid's all in. What's left in that bottle?
You can't give him that.
Why not? What do you want to drink, pal?
Hey, I was watching that.
Oh, look, he's shy.
Oh, give the kid a drink. Whose bottle is it anyway? And shift up. You should be drinking in your condition.
Well, whose fault's that? I suppose a little drop won't harm him.
It's the best medicine I know.
There you are, treasure. Off you go. Off to sleep now. Off you go.
What on earth are you doing?
What's it look like? Cleaning? Tidying? I said after it.
What for?
Neat's doing.
Why don't you leave that, love?
Why don't you start it? You find him?
No.
He'll come home when he's hungry.
Yes, and where did he sleep last night?
Oh, he'll have found somewhere. He's got his post office savings book. He can draw money out. He's got £27 in it.
The police have got it. A boy picked it up and handed it in.
He lost it? But he wouldn't do that. He's ever so careful.
I know that. It was found.
Where?
In the city. Not far from the river. Look, he wouldn't.
I know he wouldn't.
He shouldn't do this. He should make her cry.
It's all right, Laura.
He's just punishing people. Was he ever wanting to be nice to him all the time?
Run along, darling. I'll speak to you later.
Run along?
Shh.
Me too. Why don't you listen? You didn't tell him anything. That's why he ran away. You just let him find out things on his own. He was scared. Scared of his real parents coming. And I was horrible to him. We all were. And some of it was my fault.
Laura!
It serves you right he ran away. I wish I'd gone with him. Though you love him much more than you love me, so you wouldn't care, would you? In that brandy. We should have put some water in it. But a cup of tea will pick you up.
What, air of a dog? Fixing my Bloody Mary.
Move your feet, Jake.
Oh, I'm sorry. It's not very often we get to entertain famous visitors. Well, it's all there in black and white, isn't it?
My mother will be worried about me. I need to get home.
No, relax. Take it easy.
Can I get pots, please?
No.
Sit down, Mother. Just... Where's Paul?
Out. So what do you want to eat? Some chicken? Get something down inside you. People come and go here. But it's like you're turning out to be a bit special. Like she wants you to stay. So you stay, sunshine.
Say what you got to say, Mr. Fowles.
It's a terrible thing to have a boy gone missing. I wanted you to know that I bore him no malice. I was put out about the inheritance and all that. And if she'd not left her money to the boy, she'd have found a way to cut me out somehow. I was too close to her daughter, you see. Dorothy, her name was. Tied hand and foot to her mother. I can't stand it, Eric. I'm going to clear off one of these days, she'd say to me. Well, she did, didn't she? It was a bloke she knew where she worked. Hospital porter. Chinese, unpronounceable name. She called him Lee. Singapore Chinese. Never told her mother. She wouldn't have approved. It was him Dorothy went off with. Went off to Singapore. No forwarding address. Very sudden. And if she married him, well, how many Lees do you suppose there are over there? And she didn't have a baby. And if she did, it'd have different eyes from yours. Yes, well, I didn't come here to intrude on your grief. I just wanted you to know my position, that's all. There's the matter of the small things I took from the house.
Yes, that'll be all right, Mr. Foles.
I just wanted to offer you my condolences. I shall pray for your boy.
I'd give anything. Even if she was his real mother. Whoever she was, and she wanted to see him. Just so long as he's safe.
Don't cry, Mum. Please don't cry. He'll come back. Or we'll find him. I'll find him. I know a way.
That's right. A bit of peace and quiet. Jake, get in here. Clear this up. Want a bowl of hot water? Come on, shift yourself. If you want dinner, you best get cleared up, all right? Can't leave him for 2 minutes. What are you looking at me like that for?
Why won't you let me go? I asked him I could come home. Just for the night. Not to be kidnapped.
Hang on.
Can't let you just go home on your own. I love you, not with the police looking for you. Oh, ta-ra. That got me in the right spot, you did. Getting yourself in the news like that. Oh, that's better.
If you let me go home, I won't say where I've been. I don't even know where I am.
You noticed on the way home, though, wouldn't you?
I wouldn't tell.
You're an orphan, aren't you?
I don't know. I'm adopted.
Oh, foundling.
Yes.
Left by the river, eh? Don't know who your real mum is, do you?
I don't want to know.
In case she's going to come and take you away.
Don't want that.
Well, I don't think it's very likely. Oh, leaving you like she did. She did that for a reason. There's always a reason. She did her best, see? Carried you as long as she could. And then when she couldn't hold you no longer, she set you down where she knew someone was going to find you. Mm-hmm. They know where she'd gone and what she'd done. She's tired of life. Not everyone is strong enough. Do you understand? Let her rest in peace. Don't fret, she'll mock that. You like your new mum and dad, don't you?
Yes.
Well, you're a lucky lad then, ain't you? Hey? Good parents, nice home, I dare say. You ought to be ashamed of yourself running off like that. They could be out of their mind with worry. You never thought of that, did you?
Well, it's you that told the others I couldn't go home or anything.
Yeah, well, we'll have to think of a way, eh?
Thank you.
What are you doing?
Thinking about Alex. Trying to...
What?
Bring him back. See, there was this tent at the fair on Alex's finding day with a preacher and a congregation. And it wasn't like an ordinary church. They were waving their arms about and calling out names, asking the Lord to help them find missing people.
Well, that's a form of prayer, that's all.
I was thinking, if it worked for them...
I don't think it'll do any good, Laura. I don't think that by asking for something you can automatically get what you want, you know.
Nothing else has worked, though, has it?
No.
Prayer's a sort of concentration, isn't it? Like fixing your mind.
Yes, yes.
All I could think about was a toad. Alex, with a toad.
Whatever brought that into your head?
I don't know. I was trying to think of Alex. What I'd do if I was him. Put myself in his place. All I got was this toad.
But what would you do if you were Alex?
I'm not Alex.
Yes, but if you were.
I would wait in a park. Hang around a police station. A school, maybe. He's so sensible. He's not like me. He's not stubborn.
No. No, forget about you. Think about him.
Wait, where there's lots of people. That's it.
Wait.
Yes.
What for?
That's it. That's it. Don't you see? That's what I'd do. I'd wait till I was found.
Kiddo, you'll know where you are. Remember the deal?
Yes.
There you are. Back where you started from. Just about. You're on your own now. You enjoy all that money, eh? And no peeping! Start counting then!
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20.
Wow, that was pretty good. Yeah.
And there's another great story on Children's ITV tomorrow morning. It's the story...
Last of the Summer Wine, laid down as a special feature-length film.
You're paying too much for a licence fee now.
Well, you can't complain at the price for what you get.
They're right fiddled with the money we pay now.
I don't think you can actually beat it.
If you want.
On BBC One. At 8.35 tonight, a famous film star shoots a chat show host. So we've called in Perry Mason to take on the case of the shooting star. Before that on BBC One, we indulge ourselves with a full-length edition of Last of the...